Ball Facts coming back at you again, and we gonna give you the facts. Okay, the youngest Ball brother, LaMelo, does it again. Let's watch these clips, let's talk about them, and then get into the details afterwards. Oh my gosh, how fast he threw that ball with one arm off the dribble. That is tough. You will never see that pass coming, ever. Oh, through the contact. Young boy got some weight on him. Thought he was pulling right there. Ooh, them passes be on point. I love when I see his teammates take only one or two dribble and make the shot. I'm like, assist. Oh, but he always follows his shot, always. I think that was a travel or something. Oh well, could have been a foul too. Let's go, bang. Tap your head, let's roll. Oh, no mellow tap. Ooh, you gotta be scared in front of them dribbles. That shot looked horrible. Good shot. Off the inbound. They be pushing LaMelo. They not trying to let it go down like that. Ooh. Do-si-do, boy. Look at that. Kick in the air. Bing. Oh my gosh, that spin move, he's been able to do a spin move, but he's bringing it out the bag more. He must be practicing with Jermaine. Oh, LaMelo in transition, this is tough. He barely got it, but he got it. He looked at that dude too. Let's go, let's go. Ooh. That's it, Melo dip. Let's see how good he got this dunk. Oh, he got it in there. His hezzy is crazy. Oh my gosh. He threw that off there on purpose. Oh man, he just playing with them now. He's playing with these guys. Let's go. Dang, the score is 1 point difference. How did they lose this game? The shooting. Conrad, that one-handed pass would just be perfect. Got him. Nice touch. Ooh, I thought he's coming with another. Ooh, jelly. Okay, so let's talk about this game. They lost. And I gotta admit it, it's LaMelo's fault. Why? Because the brother went 1-for-11 from 3-point range. I mean, we know that LaMelo can have shooting slumps and he's streaky sometimes, but 1-for-11, you are better than that. And it says a lot that you still get a triple-double, still drop 25 points, and you miss those threes. But it's kind of like James Harden. Like, if they win, it's because of James Harden. If they lose, it's because of James Harden. You'll look at the stat sheet and see, like, dang, 50 points they won. The next game, he'll have 30 points, made 15 free throws, but from the three-point range, he was like 2-for-15. And you say, okay, they lost because of James Harden. So they lost because LaMelo. And I feel bad for RJ Hampton. RJ Hampton, he gets 12 points and people try not to leave him out. They're like, LaMelo did this and did that. And RJ just got 12 points, even though RJ's team won the game. But LaMelo's a difference maker. And like I said last time, they weren't going to say anything about the key free throws he missed because he won. But in this one, we got to talk about those free throws because you missed them. You can't miss those. That's the only thing they have with LeBron James over Michael Jordan. If you watch ESPN sometimes, they used to say, oh, LeBron's good, but he didn't make his free throws. Michael Jordan would have made those free throws. So, LaMelo, you got to make those free throws. But I will say, his passing ability, I mean, his aggression, everything that we want to see in Lonzo, this kid brings out. So, to get one triple-double in the NBL is big, let alone to be the youngest to do it. But then he comes back and drops another one right after just to show them, like, that's easy. That's easy to do. In his last four games, he had 19, 24, 16, 32, and now 25. He's showing them that he will be an elite scorer in the NBL. He just needed to get his feet wet. He just needed to gain the coach's confidence. And now he has it. What LaMelo does, the coach is going to approve. He's going to ride his coattails and say, if we win, we'll win because of you. If we lose, we'll lose because of you. I don't care if you are 1-for-11. You're getting your minutes. And that's all we've been waiting for. We've been waiting to see. And so this is a good game to put in his catalog, because why? When you're in the league, you're going to have shooting nights like this, like I mentioned James Harden does. But can you still keep your head up and go get a bucket? Can you still keep shooting? Because at the last second, some people make shots and they've been missing all game, but you need to shoot every shot with confidence. Confidence is key. Now, this guy is putting pressure on all the draft picks, because I don't think any of them has his confidence or his poise. But y'all let me know in the comment section what y'all think about this game, what y'all think about LaMelo's draft stock. Comment, like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Ball facts again. Peace.